Hey guys, so today's workout is going to be a 40 minute high intensity workout. You can do it all at home. You can do it all body weight or with dumbbells. I'm going to be using 15 pound dumbbells, so you can decide whatever works best for you, or a kettlebell would also work. Make sure you have a water, some good shoes, gym clothes on, and your workout buddy or supportive partner. So this is Flynn. He's gonna be my supportive buddy in every video, basically. I'm 35 weeks pregnant tomorrow, so if I can do these workouts, you can do these workouts. And just so you guys know, if there's ever a workout that you're a little bit too tired to keep doing, just make modifications and you can slow down, but don't stop. So I know you guys can do it. I'm gonna start the timer and you'll listen to it as we go and watch me and work out together, right? Okay, perfect. So first we're gonna do reverse lunges. You can do these body weight. You can hold a kettlebell at your chest or you can hold dumbbells in your hands. Totally up to you. But let's get the timer going. Okay, hold it right there. So I'm gonna hold my dumbbells for as long as I can and move his butt out of the way. And I like to do mine all in one leg and then switch legs each round. So since we spend 4 minutes on each workout and there's 10 different workouts, I'm technically doing 4 rounds on each leg and 8 rounds total. So how Tabata works is you work for 20 seconds and rest for 10 and then switch or do the round again. And these are just reverse lunges. So we want to make sure our chest is staying up tall. You're squeezing your core the whole time. Whew. And you're just lunging back. So you totally got this. Deep breaths. And I love this timer because it tells you when to stop and go. And you don't even have to look at it. So make sure you're switching legs each time. Or switching legs with each rep, however you want to do it. And if you get too tired, just put the weight down and do body weight. And if you're doing body weight and getting too tired, just slow down a little bit and keep going, because we don't stop. We gotta keep working. And switch. But yeah, we're only not even 2 minutes in yet, and I'm already ready for some water. So that's why I tell you guys, start with the water, because you only have 10 second breaks. So you kind of have to be smart with your time that you spend resting. But yeah, I'll be 35 weeks pregnant tomorrow. Check out that belly. Whew. And I've had a really great pregnancy. There's not much I can complain about at all. But I think it's because I've been exercising 5 days a week. I'm doing workouts like this, or I go lift light weights. And I've been trying to eat healthy. So that's been my secret, I guess. Staying active, even on the days that it doesn't feel very great to be active. And balance has gotten pretty tricky, but that's okay. We just keep pushing through, and we are on a serious countdown in our house for this baby boy to come. Whew. We just have one more on each leg. You can totally do it. You got this. Keep it up as many as you can. It's only 20 seconds. Whenever you get too tired, just keep telling yourself, it's only 20 seconds. I got this. That's what I do. Because anyone can do anything for 20 seconds, right? That's what I choose to believe. pushing. We're almost done. This is our last round. And then we're gonna move on to plank toe taps. Okay, put your weights down. Grab a quick drink. And then get your plank. And how this works is your hand taps your opposite foot. So my left hand is tapping my right toe. And this isn't a very fast movement. It's more slow and controlled. And you're just squeezing your core. And then we'll rest here until it's time to get into our next plank. But yeah, you're squeezing your core. Don't let your hips sink down, but also don't shoot your butt in the air. You can see when I'm balancing really well and when I'm not. By keeping your feet about shoulder width apart helps a lot, instead of right together. Deep breaths. Back up in your plank. And I don't count rounds because I feel like 8 is a lot. I just go by the minute. So if I've been going for 2 minutes and I know I have 2 minutes left, and 2 is just a better number than 4. We got this. Keep it up. Gotta balance. Control your breathing and focus on that core strength to keep you balanced. And then you're gonna have no problem at all. So this is our 2 minute mark. This is when I say it's all downhill. Keep it up. Tap your toes. Make sure you're going opposites.
3, 2, 1.
And even if you're not pregnant, these workouts are super effective. So don't count them off just because you're not pregnant. Pregnancies just makes it a little bit harder because you're carrying so much extra weight. And everything's shifting. And your hips tend to hurt more and your glutes. Getting ready for that baby. Okay, last minute. Your breathing. You guys are doing so awesome at home. I know you are. This is such a great workout. You're going to find yourself sweating a lot. And getting results in no time, which is what we love, right? We love results. Ooh. Last one. Up in your plank. Squeeze. This is your last one, and you can do anything for 20 seconds. Woo. Include balance. Okay, go ahead and stand. Next, we have our modified burpees. My lighting's all messed up. Okay, so you're gonna go down, pop your feet out, up to your hands, bring your chest up, back, chest up, pop out, and in. So the movement itself is super simple, and you're just holding that squat basically the whole time. Go ahead and stand. The sun changing is really screwing things up for me. Okay. Sorry, I know you guys love close-ups of my face. Bring that chest up. We got this. You can do normal burpees here if you want. Then stand to rest. I choose to be modified because sometimes when you get tired in a normal burpee, you end up just throwing yourself on the ground, which isn't the best if you have a big belly with a cute little baby in it. So this way, my belly is never getting to the ground, and I'm relying on my legs to do all the work. But they definitely burn super bad. But it's okay. We got this. And in our high intensity workouts, you know exactly how long you have to do an exercise so you can push through that burn and tell yourself that it will be over soon. And you're not even lying to yourself. Because 4 minutes is 4 minutes. And then we move on. And we're halfway done with these. Just gotta push through. This last half of modified burpees. Get that chest up, hit your squat. Whew. Deep breath. If you're not breathing, then your muscles aren't getting any oxygen. And that hurts a whole lot more than if you just breathe slowly. Three more, guys. We got this. Each one is only 20 seconds. And you guessed it. Anyone can do anything for 20 seconds. Breathe. I know it burns. My muscles are getting tight. Stand and stretch it out. Two more. So close to being done. And we're already over a quarter of the way done with the whole workout, which is like the best news. You got this. Keep it up. Keep pushing. Just one more. We can do one more. You have it in you. If you are just so tired right now, just set yourself a number and try and hit the number. That number could be 30. And just tell yourself that you want to get 3 in 20 seconds. And if you hit 3 and there's still some time left, go for one more. Okay. Next workout is our goblet squats. So you're going to need one of your weights. Hold it up at your chest. Then you're just squatting down, coming straight back up. So our rest periods are so short in high intensity workouts, but our work periods are only 20 seconds. You gotta breathe, right? Okay, and if you have a kettlebell, you can hold that at your chest also. I'm just holding up one of my 15-pound dumbbells, keeping my chest up as tall as I can, squeezing my core, because even though there's a baby in there, my muscles still work. So baby or not, just squeeze your core muscles, which are your abs. 1 minute down. Here we go. Just as many as you can with good form. Trust me, your form matters so much more than the number of reps you're getting. You got this. Squeeze. Perfect. Drink water as you need it. In any of your 10-second rest, if you want to get water, I highly encourage it. Your muscles perform better when you breathe and they're hydrated. So throughout the whole day, you want to drink as much water as you can. If you're a big soda drinker and you want to cut back on your soda, try and drink a water between each soda and not just like a sip of water. Try and make it a water bottle or a big container of water or whatever you have. I like refillable bottles just because I drink so much water in the day. And I love using a straw. That's another tip I have for you. If you find yourself struggling to drink enough water in the day, you should try using a straw. Because I think people drink more when they use a straw. Deep breaths. You got this. Make sure your knees are going out and your chest is staying up. Great job. Just two more. See how fast it goes by? It's so nice. Deep breaths. Squeeze your core. Get those knees out. You got this. Chest up. Don't look at the ground. Look up or in front of you. That will help you keep that chest up. And we have push-ups next, which are going to be super fun. Remember, if you are getting so tired, just put your weight down. And if you're doing body weight, just slow down. But do not stop. You are totally capable of finishing this workout. I know you are. Okay, put your weight down. Take a drink. And get in your push-up position. As many as you can. If you can't quite do strict push-ups, just start on your knees. And do as many as you can from your knees. You got this. I like to do as many as I can strict and then go to my knees when I'm too tired to keep going. So I'll start this round strict also. But when I get too tired, I'll go to my knees. My knees have just gotten so hard. Good job, guys. So now that my arms are fried, I'm gonna go to my knees. On your knees, squeeze your core. Don't hang your head. Keep those hips tucked. That's part of squeezing your core. Just as many as you can in 20 seconds. It's only 20 seconds. And then we have our fantastic 10 second rest. And this is why you need a workout buddy, because they can tell you to keep going if you're getting tired. Deep breaths. Head up. Squeeze your core. You got this. Just as many as you can. Get a drink if you need it. We're already halfway done with these. So it's already going by so fast, right? And then, after these push-ups, we'll be halfway done with the whole workout. And that is exciting. But yeah, I've basically been doing these high-intensity workouts throughout my whole pregnancy. I switched from heavy weightlifting before pregnancy to high intensity once I found out I was pregnant. And I tried to be the girl that just kept lifting weights. But my body was just so, so tired in my first trimester. And I couldn't quite keep my form the way that I knew I needed to if I wanted to keep lifting weights. So I changed to high intensity at home, canceled my gym membership, and bought some dumbbells for my house. And now I'm working out with you. Listen to this song. We can do this. Keep going. Just one more. And then we're gonna do some sumo squat pulses, which I really enjoy. And you will too. Last one. Come on, as many as you can with good form, taking deep breaths. Keep that head up, don't hang it. Squeeze. Almost done. Good job, good drink. Okay, stand up. Put your feet wide apart in a wide stance. These are sumo squat pulses. So we're just gonna stay here for our 20 seconds of work. And then we'll just stand for 10 seconds of rest and go right back into it for each round. Good. You got this. And like I said, if you're getting tired and you're not sure if you can keep going, just slow those pulses down to about here and focus on your breathing. And don't focus on the time. I don't feel like that helps very much because we can hear a timer. Go ahead and stand. But squats of any kind and lunges, if you're pregnant, they're gonna help strengthen that pelvic floor. So it's really important to include them in whatever exercise routine you have. And if you're not pregnant, hey, they're great for toning, right? So you should do them anyway. But we're just here. Timer tells us to stop and we rest. I had to take a few steps out of it just to help my body not be so tight. Otherwise I'd just fall right over. So here we are. Keep going. We are halfway done with this workout, guys. And that is good news. Keep going. Good. Take a few steps, let your body get loose. And we're halfway done with these. Goes by so fast. Keep going. These workouts go by so much faster than any weightlifting workout that I ever did in the gym, because I'm only working for 20 seconds and then resting for 10. So I'm always doing something. And we make sure that our work periods are longer than our rest periods, which also helps a ton. Three more. You got this. And that sumo squat and pulse it out. However bad it hurts, you are gonna pulse through it and keep going. Squeezing our core. Always, always, always squeeze your core. Keep your chest up and let your legs do the work. Take those few steps that you need. And we just have two more. And that's good news. Whew. Down in your squat. Pulse it out. And I also love working out at home, because I don't feel judged at all. I mean, there's no one here to judge me. So I listen to the music I want. I write the workout I want to do. Walk it out. I wear whatever clothes I want. I don't have to match. It's super nice. No one's watching. I mean, you guys are watching, but I've already got the workout done, so it doesn't really matter what you guys think. And if you're watching it this long, I hope you're actually doing it with me and feeling this burn. Because these high intensity workouts will tone you up so fast. Good. Okay. Next. Now we have our side plank weight shifts. So you're going to get in a side plank. Grab your dumbbell. If you don't have a dumbbell, that's totally fine. You'll just do it without it. So I'm just moving the weight out as far as I can and into me, just like this, holding up my side plank, and I'm keeping my hips high, not hanging them down low. Perfect. And then we'll switch sides. Get that hair out of the way. Almost done. Up in your plank, out and in. Side plank weight shifts. You got this. It's only 20 seconds, and I totally believe that you can do this for 20 seconds. And it's only 4 rounds on each side. So we're already on our second round for this side. So don't think of it as, oh my gosh, I have 8 rounds of this. Think of it as, I have 4 rounds of this. And don't doubt yourself. Encourage yourself and say, I can do this for 4 rounds. Because you can do it for 4 rounds. Let's get in that side plank. Up. And we're just moving it out and in. As many as you can. Squeezing your core. Don't forget to breathe. Keep those hips up. So this is a perfect example of why you need to have shoes on. Because it really helps with the grip. Staying in that plank. Okay, we're already into our third round. And we only have 4 rounds to do. So it's all downhill from here. Keep going. Push through. Think about why you want to do this workout. Why do you want to push yourself and find your limits in exercise? What goals are you trying to meet? And what time frame are you giving yourself to get there? Whenever you want to quit, think of the reason you started. 3, 2, 1. And that basically applies to anything in life. Right? All things get a little hard sometimes. 1. Last one on each side. We got this. Squeeze that core. We only have 3 exercises left after this. 3, 2, 1. Ooh. If this is your first time doing high intensity workouts, you have to put in the comments how you liked it. 3, 2, 1. How it went for you your first time. Up. I remember my first time was brutal. But when I wanted to get in shape, I did all body weight, high intensity exercises. 3, 2, 1. Good job. Put that weight to the side. We're going to do side lunges. 3, 2, 1. This is another one that I do all on one side, and I switch sides every 30 seconds. So just as many as you can. Keep that chest up. We're pushing off this leg. 3, 2, 1. Good. Now we'll switch sides. Breathe. 3, 2, 1. Down and push. Keeping that chest up, staying balanced. Whew. Lost my balance. You got it. Good. And these are total body workouts. So we're getting everywhere. And every workout I do, which is another reason why I love high intensity, it's different. The morning of my workout, just a few minutes before I actually start it, I sit down and write what I want to do. Good job, guys. Let's get this side done. You got this, as many as you can. Deep breaths. Push out that leg, you got this. Don't give up. Awesome. When you're tired, you just make modifications as you go. You can slow down. But no matter what you do, don't stop. You're gonna have a 10-second break so soon. And your body can recover so fast. We're teaching your body to recover quickly. Good. You guys are killing it. We just have to do this side, and then one more on each side. And we can move on to our last two workouts. Keep going. Deep breaths. Think about that reason why you want to work out. You want to feel better. You want to have more energy. You have a certain goal that you're trying to reach. Whatever your reason is, keep it in the front of your mind. Think about it the whole time. Because that reason should never leave. This pain that you feel is not greater than your reason to keep going. I promise. Because right now you're getting stronger, and all this hard work is going to pay off for you. So when you're done with this workout, you can drop in the comments what your goals are. And let me know what it is that you're working so hard towards. This is your last one. Come on, push through. Great job. Okay, now I have inchworms, which I'll show you how to do. So you start at the top where your feet are. Walk your hands out. Hit your plank. Come back to your feet. And back out. Again, this isn't super rushed because we want to get in that plank position at the bottom and make it back to your toes. And then back to your toes. Just as many of those as you can in your 20 seconds. And you should feel your core, really. So we have to squeeze our core right. Back to your toes. But remember, when it comes to your fitness goals, your health goals, and anything like that, nutrition plays a much bigger role than exercise. Drink your water. You got this, just 3 more minutes of these. So yeah, always keep your nutrition in mind. And do the best you can making healthy substitutions. If you're really craving something sweet, try adding an apple or a fruit. And just start making slow changes that way. Encourage your body to make those healthy changes. And then soon, those will be your cravings. down and out. If you need more help with nutrition, you're welcome to put in the comments and reach out to me, and I'm happy to help you because you get results so much faster with these workouts when you take care of your nutrition. And results keep us going, right? Motivation gets us started, and results keep us going. Because one day, you're not gonna be very motivated to work out or eat healthy, and that's okay. It's just how it goes. But your reason to keep going needs to get you back on track and back in gear every time you want to give up and stop. I mean, being pregnant, there's lots of days that I don't want to work out. But the reason I keep going is because I know really soon this baby's coming. Whether or not I decided to exercise and eat healthy throughout my pregnancy or not, he's growing, and when he's ready, he's gonna come. So if I wanna have a little bit of a smoother labor and delivery and recovery, then it's important for me to stay in shape now and take care of my health. Last one. Just as many as you can, right? And then after I have him, I'm gonna take that 6 weeks off that they recommend so your body can heal. And I'll just be going on walks with my cute dog and my cute boy. But these kind of workouts aren't gonna happen for 6 weeks. Now your mountain climbers, down in a plank. And you're gonna drive your knees into your chest, as many as you can. Here's a secret, if you want these to be easier, squeeze your core. That's my secret. Because I promise, the more you squeeze, the easier it is, the lighter you feel. Oh, come on. Last part of our entire workout. Last 4 minutes, back at it. Squeeze. You've already destroyed 9 exercises. This is the last one. Focus on your breathing and on squeezing, and that will help you out a bunch. Just 3 more minutes, okay? You got this. Don't give up. These mountain climbers are a perfect example of when you get tired and you want to stop. Because it is a bit of a faster movement, but when you're too tired to keep going, you just have to slow down. 2, 1. You got this. This is our halfway one. And then it's all downhill from here. As many as you can. Squeeze your core. I promise it helps. Give it a try. Let yourself succeed. Finish this workout strong. We're halfway done. 2 more minutes. Deep breaths. Back at it. As many as you can, guys. And don't give up. Keep going. Whew. Great. Deep breaths. Control that breathing. Okay, right back into it. We just have 3 to do. and then you are all done. Keep going, keep going. Come on, just two more. Don't give up. Feel empowered, feel strong, and create that confidence that you know you can finish. Deep breaths, control it in and out. Squeeze that core. You just have one more. You guys have totally killed this whole workout. Now we just have our last round of mountain climbers to do. As many as you can. This is your last round. You don't have to do it again today. Just as many as you can right here, right now, until that timer tells you to stop. You gotta keep pushing. And you finished. Thank you guys so much for working out with me today. Go ahead and put in the comments if you've tried high intensity before, or if this is your first time doing it, and how you guys liked the workout. I'm totally open to feedback. Yay for being 35 weeks pregnant tomorrow and still exercising. And I hope that I'm encouraging you guys to take care of your health in a more positive and beneficial way. Keep working towards your goals. Utilize your exercise and nutrition capabilities, and everything will turn out being a lot easier for you. But drink lots of water to recover, stretch. If you have a lacrosse ball to use, get on your muscles, your hip flexors and glutes with your lacrosse ball as you stretch. And that will help a ton with your recovery. But see how healthy you can eat today, and that will help you reach your goals a lot faster. But I'll see you guys tomorrow.